The contents of this video are for informational purposes only. Please consult the manufacturer's guidelines and use and care instructions before beginning.
Hi, Pat Clark here with Lifting Gear Hire Corporation. Today we're going to discuss polyester slings, sling selection for your application, identification and inspection of slings, and we're going to give you a demonstration on properly test loading the slings. For openers, we'd like to talk about sling identification and tags that must be permanently affixed to the sling themselves. Clearly marked on each tag must be the manufacturer, the serial number, the type, length, and the various hitches. For example, on this particular sling, we have the vertical, choker, and respective basket hitch. Another criteria when selecting a polyester round sling is their ability to stretch under load. In addition to that, when they're manufactured out of the facility, they'll also have some tolerance as well. For example, this EN series sling that we're looking at now has the ability to stretch up to 3% at full load. In addition to that, when it's manufactured, there's a tolerance of plus or minus 1 inch plus an additional 1% of total length of sling. This is important for headroom purposes when you're planning your application. This KN series can stretch up to 1% of total length, is also made with tolerances plus or minus 1 inch plus an additional 1% of total length. This braided series also has the ability to stretch at full load, 9% and plus or minus 2% of total length. In addition, at manufacturing, it is plus or minus 2 inches plus 5% of total length. You should also avoid getting these slings wet. Now, although there's no significant reduction in the capacity, the sling can stretch up to an additional 4% on top of what we discussed earlier.
When it comes to sling selection, a qualified person should base their decision on factors such as type of material, environment, the different hitch configurations, durations at different sling angles, length of the slings, and any headroom specifications.
Now we want to discuss the makeup of these slings as well as the daily inspection criteria. These slings are made up of inner core yarns protected by an inner and an outer protective sleeve. Every day before use, we want to inspect the entire length of the sling. We're looking for things like evidence of heat damage, chemical damage, ultraviolet ray damage, holes, cuts, tears, snags, or anything that would expose the inner core yarns. If these criteria are not met, we must remove this sling from daily use immediately. After the inspection is complete, you are now able to apply the slings to perform a test lift. Be sure to consult the manufacturer's guidelines as to the minimum hardware requirements. These slings must be derated if the guidelines are not followed. It is crucial to protect the slings from sharp corners that may cause damage to the slings. A qualified person must determine the proper material and size softener that is needed. Although it may be necessary to perform several test lifts and inspections of both slings and softeners before suitability is determined, please remember that no softener or sling is cut proof. At Lifting Gear Hire Corporation, we have vertical capacity ranges from 31,000 all the way up to 306,000 pounds. We hope that you found this demonstration helpful. For more information on this product and others, give us a call. As a reminder, the contents of this video were for informational purposes only. Please consult the manufacturer's guidelines and use and care instructions before beginning.